In large swaths of the northern hemisphere around the Arctic Circle, a major disaster is lurking which will likely devastate regional economies and cause as much as $276 billion in damage by 2065 due to a prominent geologic hazard. This disaster is slow-moving, but will cause many bridges to crack, roads to buckle, buildings to collapse, and even theoretically cause certain communities to completely collapse below sea level. I am not referring to volcanic eruptions or earthquakes, and no, I am not referring to methane or carbon dioxide gas that is trapped below ground in many of these locations being released into the atmosphere. Instead, I am talking about an often forgotten hazard that could make it in the long term too expensive to live in some locations and force migrations of some of the approximately 5 million people which live there. This represents a worst-case scenario due to the effects of permafrost melting, which could place as much as 50% of all infrastructure which lies on top of existing permafrost at high risk of foundation damage by only 2050. This damage is forecasted to occur at certain towns in Alaska, northern Canada, Russia, Finland, Sweden, Norway, Iceland, and Greenland. To help portray this problem, I present this hillside along the Robert Service Way Road in the Yukon town of Whitehorse, which I visited in person quite recently. As this hillside has repeatedly been the site of landslides during the last 5 years, blocking sections of the road. While landslides can occur due to a large variety of reasons, permafrost melting is strongly to blame here. As lying underneath sections of Whitehorse and its surrounding regions is a non-continuous layer of hard, permanently frozen ground known as permafrost, which if you were to attempt to break would be tougher than concrete. Simply dig down as little as 3 meters or approximately 10 feet and you might encounter a several foot thick mass of ice. Ice can compose as much as 30% to as even as high as 80% by volume of permafrost, so when this melts it causes two problems. First, due to warming temperatures, the permafrost layer is decreasing in thickness, meaning sections of ice possibly frozen for more than 10,000 years will melt, adding significant moisture into the soil. This can subsequently destabilize weak overlying rock units, especially if they are rich in clay, causing them to partially collapse in various landslides. However, the second hazard is even more concerning. As permafrost melts, the ice within it turns to water before eventually evaporating, never to be replaced. When this occurs, what used to represent as much as 80% of a layer of ground no longer exists, causing the ground to subside, sometimes in an uneven manner. This means that all infrastructure which exists on top of subsiding ground might be severely damaged and possibly even collapse. Since the thickness of permafrost varies from a few inches to more than 4,000 feet thick across the affected areas in the northern hemisphere, if all this permafrost were to thaw and the ice within it melt away, the most extreme cases where there was several thousand feet thick of permafrost could see large swaths of ground drop more than 100 feet in elevation. However, a complete collapse in the short term currently appears unlikely, and although I could not find a firm number, in my opinion, as much as the top 10 feet of permafrost may disappear by 2100, causing inches to feet of ground subsidence. And this is the primary threat posed to a section of Whitehorse, parts of Fairbanks, but also the majority of Dawson City, and millions of others who live across an area greater than the combined size of the entirety of the United States, Canada, Mexico, Greenland, and Paraguay, totaling an area of 22.8 million square kilometers. Such foundation problems can be seen, for example, at this abandoned hut in Alaska, which could represent the future of tens or even hundreds of thousands of structures. At Point Lay in Alaska, one person even noted a ground subsidence of 8 feet underneath his house during the last 30 years. The two largest cities which are likely to be affected by this hazard are currently both in Russia, containing a combined population of 490,000 residents. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.